Welcome to Smiling Professor. My name is Bukala, and today in this video, we're going to be continuing our conversation with Miss Neni. So this is actually a part two to the first video I did last week. So we had an amazing conversation with Miss Neni, and I got a lot of positive feedback on the video because there was a lot of lessons to be learned from both her life, her academic experiences. An example is I spoke to her about taking advantages of opportunity when it presents itself. I actually asked her a question in regards to this, and she emphasized how when you're taking advantage of an opportunity, you have to make sure that it's legal. If you haven't watched the first part of the video, why she emphasized on it being legal is because she's actually a trained lawyer, and she has to make sure that whatever advice she's giving must be legal. So I don't know why I'm telling you about this. You can just watch the video. The link to the first part of the video is down in the comment section below. Before we go to discuss today's topic, I'd like to say thank you to everybody who subscribed to my channel so far and has taken time out to comment on my videos. If you're new here and you have not yet subscribed, please take the time out to subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking the red button below. So now let's just go straight into the video, the part two of the conversation with Miss Neni.
What skills do you think that young ladies would need?
You need to be hardworking. Hard work is a skill. The ability to be hardworking is a skill. You have to manage your time. Time management is a skill. Organization is a skill. I know that, yes, a lot of us have temperaments. We like to be laid back, especially the flags. My younger sister is a flag, but she always shows up on time. She's relaxed, she's chilled, but when it comes to, she might have it all in her head, but she always shows up. Sometimes she might be 5 minutes late. We can forgive her for that. But she always shows up on time. So you have to have time management skills. You have to have people skill. Human beings generally, they can be the most difficult people to handle, to deal with. You have to have people skills. You have to understand the perspective that a particular person is addressing an issue. You might be talking to somebody about a particular thing, but you're addressing it from your own perspective. You have to understand where the person is addressing your own suggestion or question from and try and meet the person halfway. Sometimes people might not want to meet you halfway, but then the burden is on you. My father once said to me, in trying to teach me how to drive, he said to me, "Believe everybody on the road is mad. You are the only sane person on that road. So the burden is on you to avoid every motor crash and try and advise anybody that is not turning well. Straighten your hand, oh girl. Straighten your hand, madam." So please, you have to learn people skills. Have that interpersonal skills with people. Because having people skills, interpersonal skills with them, it breeds maturity. And a lot of organizations, especially the one I work for, they want to see that sense of maturity within you. That you don't crack under pressure, you don't cry anyhow. Yes, we're allowed to be emotional people, but be able to handle a certain level of pressure. So those are the skills I would advise you. Be hardworking, be organized, have time management skills, have people skills. It would help you. And have discipline. You need to have principles and you need to be disciplined. Those two, they go hand in hand. Do not follow people of questionable character, because an adage goes, the friend of a thief is also a thief. So no matter what you are doing, even though you are the one that is not stealing, you never stole in your life, the fact that you are friends with that thief, they will associate you with that person. Everybody has to each his own, but when you know where you're going, you need to adhere to that and be disciplined. In being disciplined, there are some opportunities that will come to you that, because you are disciplined and you are principled, no matter how that opportunity will help you, your principles would question it and say, okay, hold on, it might help me, but in the nearest future, will I regret this? There are some opportunities you should say no to, no matter how it will help you. That is where being disciplined comes in.
Thank you so much. I feel we're learning, Neni. I feel we're learning a lot from you. Honestly, like, thank you so much. You spoke about a mentor of yours.
Yes.
Yeah, so do you have other mentors, and do you think having a mentor is important?
Yes, having a mentor is important. I'm someone who is very spiritual. I'm a Christian, so I have a spiritual mentor. I also have mentors for different things, because everybody, you can't be jack of all trades. One person is an expert in the area where you want to learn from. So you cannot follow someone that is a jack of all trades and master of none. No. We pick from, as a lawyer, we're taught to pick from different aspects. So I have a mentor. Strife is one of my mentors. I have a spiritual mentor. I also have, I love to see women being empowered. I love to see where women set their goals and they are achieving it. So I am surrounded by powerful, strong women. The interviewer of this video is one of the people that I look up to. Yes, I thought I was weird when I came to, when I started my PhD. I thought I was weird because I was all over the place. I couldn't find balance. But speaking with her, I understood that yes, I am even a low level of what I think I am, but she's one of my mentors. I have Dr. Sally. Dr. Sally is one of my mentors because she's passionate for people. She has a heart for people. She's chasing after things. She's helping people. She's involved in charity work. She's a philanthropist. So I have mentors all over. I mean, and the mentors that I have, I will not name. I don't know how to name plenty of them because I'm not going to name plenty of them because you might not know. A lot of people might not know all of them, but the mentors I have are the people that they are close to me, they are within reach, and if I ever have a question, yes, their expectations, they are meeting it, but they can help me bridge that gap between expectation and my reality. So don't have mentors that are far away from you that cannot checkmate you when you do certain things. I have my mentors, I can call them on the phone and they checkmate me for every step, and the interviewer in this video is one of them. She checkmates me every time with respect to my PhD, with respect to my life generally. When I was doing my MBA, she was my lecturer. Yes, she lectured me when I was doing my MBA, and I was able to balance that because I wanted to learn. So I gave her that respect in class. If you want to learn, you shouldn't take yourself higher than the person who wants to teach you. If you feel like you know everything, there's no need for you to learn. So if you want to learn and you know that someone can teach you that thing, you have to calm down, bring yourself to the level of being teachable. So the interviewer is amazing. She checkmates me every now and then. And yes, I surround myself with really strong women who are my mentors because I'm a strong woman myself. And these women, they have gone ahead of me. They are setting the pace. They have set the pace and are still setting the pace. And I am just walking behind them. So they know quite a lot of things, especially when it comes to balancing your life as a whole, be it in academically, socially, intellectually, you, everything is there.
Thank you so much. You've been amazing so far. And yeah, but you spoke about your surrounding, the people you network with. Do you think that your friends actually help you get to your destination? Do you think having the right friends help you get to your destination? You said something brief about it. What do you think? Or do you think it doesn't matter? You can surround yourself with anyone you want to.
I think it matters that you surround yourself with people that matter. Because like I explained, a friend of mine told me that a dead clock will tell you the right time twice in a day if it is a 12-hour clock. So yes, I surround myself with people that matter, people that can help me. And it might seem that the influence that they have is minor, it's not major, but little drops of water make a mighty ocean. You need the little things, little grains of sand can make a desert. So a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a step. You need little things, little people. I will give an example. I never knew how to do my makeup. I met a fantastic friend. She was able, because I'm a very monochrome person, black, white, gray, blue. Those are just the four colors I go to shop for. And I didn't really know how to do my makeup. But she is someone that combines, she pays attention to her looks. Okay, so now I'm mentioning two people. But I met the interviewer later on, but this friend, I met her before the interviewer. Every time I have said the interviewer, I mean Bukola, the smiling professor. I met this my friend before I met Bukola, and I met this friend, or I became really close to this friend before I became close to Bukola. So this friend, she paid attention to her looks, her hair, her makeup, the colors she could read, and she's really bold with colors. I see she's dark skinned like me, and I see her wear colors like orange, neon green. And I'm like, that is yellow. I'm like, that is very audacious of you. Very bold. So I made friends with her because I knew that I just didn't want, as a future professor, I didn't want boring things around me, because I mean the book is black and white alone, so I like to see colors. I'm a big fan of cartoons, so I like to see colors. And then later on, I learned how to do my makeup from her. She would do my makeup and I would watch her do it, and I started picking it up myself. So, and I also met Bukola later on, and I became really close with her. And yes, I started picking colors. I started learning how to dress as a future consultant / professor in the making. So yes, Bukola was my lecturer during my master's when I was doing my MBA. I watched how she would dress to class and how she would comport herself, how she would talk to the students and bring them up to speed. Good God, I truly salute her because she could take dozens of questions even after class, and I'd be like, would these people let us go? But she was always patient enough. She would stand and explain it step by step. Sometimes she had to take a whole summary of the class all over again, that she could do like three summaries, because the first person would have asked for a summary and the second person, who didn't pay attention, would ask for the summary again, and she would start from the beginning. So she was really patient, and I'm learning that.
She's gonna become a lecturer soon, so we're now colleagues and we can tease ourselves, and she goes like, you were once my lecturer and now we're colleagues, which is amazing, because Nelly has really done well. Like, she has two masters. Like, I always tell her like, oh my God, you have two masters.
And every time you say that, I always go like, oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah, it's like she doesn't remember sometimes, actually. She's just like, Nelly, you have two masters. And she's like, oh, that's true. So you could see she's really a humble person. I think that's part of the traits that have really gotten her really far, because I think she's always willing to learn. She said something about that. Yeah. She's always willing to learn. Like, if you know better than her, she wants to learn from you. When it relates to law, I go to her and I'm like, yes, now I'm your student. Like, now that we're colleagues, like, what do you think about this? And she puts me through. So I think it goes both ways.
Yeah, it does.
You spoke a lot about your network and people you surround yourself with. And you said that you follow people who inspire you, like your mentor, on Facebook and Instagram and things like that. So do you think that's really important? Do you think surrounding yourself with people you have similar goals with, similar drive with, is really important? Do you want to talk more about that? Because you're following people that inspire you on social media. That's amazing.
Yes, I had explained that I met a friend who taught me how to do my makeup. I would have loved to do self-learn, but as academics, it's really not easy. So she taught me how to do my makeup, how to dress, and even Bukola helped me with that, especially when she was lecturing me during my master's. So yes, it does matter. It matters who you follow. But one thing I would emphasize is, don't follow anyhow. Follow with purpose. The people I follow on Instagram are more than people that follow me. But if there's one thing I know, is that I have a purpose, a reason for following each and every one of them. And I have a reason for allowing people follow me. We as human beings, we might say, oh, there's no reason. Sometimes we might just say, oh, it's just because of this. But deep down, we know that that reason is not the main reason. We have to learn to checkmate ourselves and search deeper and expose yourself to yourself, because no other person knows you better than you. My mom would say that there are three people you cannot deceive. You cannot deceive the devil, you cannot deceive God, and you cannot deceive yourself. You know this is the truth, is the truth, accept it. So yes, who you follow is important on social media, in life, it is important. When you follow people, you have to follow them with your eyes open, so that when they make mistakes, be it in life or character-wise, you don't follow blindly and make the same mistakes they do. You see, that's how they transfer generational curses. You make the same mistakes of your parents and you have observed that pattern. It's a pattern, you need to break it. The fact that you have observed it, it means that you need to sort it out. So follow people with your eyes open. Do not follow people blindly. I cannot stress enough. Please, do not follow people blindly. I think it's good to do an overhaul. You know how influencers do like, oh, it's a fashion haul. Do a followers haul. The people you have followed 2 years ago, when you scroll through and you see that, oh, things have changed in the course of 2 years, they don't match my principles anymore. They don't do this. They don't. I know there's something called loyalty, but you might have grown, and at this stage you have grown to, at that stage, the current stage of your life, the person you're following is not helping that current stage of, it's okay to separate and come back. People, that's how the life, the race of life is. People's paths are intertwined. They come, they stay, and they can go apart. They come back, they go apart. So yes, do a follower call. The ones you don't, you, that are not encouraging your principles, your goals, for you to strive harder, it's okay to unfollow them and follow them back. That's absolutely fine. It's not about loyalty. Don't do blind loyalty, please. Even God gave us free will to think and reassess. He says, test all spirits. Reassess everything that you're doing. Reassess if, that's why we go through trials. Reassess if following God is truly worth it. That's why God always proves himself every time, over and over again, over and over again. When you go through things, you can think back and say, oh Lord, I'm thankful. So yes, please, do a haul of everybody you follow. If they don't match your goals, your principles, your values, things that you would not allow, just, you can be friends with someone from afar. You don't have to go close and intimate with that person. Always remember, a friendship is symbiotic. It's not parasitic. Please. You can't be the only one pouring into somebody and the person is not pouring to you, or the person is pouring garbage to you. A bird does not sing its best tunes when there are hunters around. The hunters will shoot it down.
Oh, thank you so much, Nani. You're speaking words. Like, honestly, you're speaking words, and we're so grateful that you made the time to come and do this. So I'm going to put Nani's Instagram and Facebook and all of that in this video, so you can follow her, obviously. And if you guys want me to interview her again, because I think I want to start this thing where I interview academics, because what happens is most academics don't come on social media for, yes, some, where I know a lot of doctors, like female doctors, like PhD doctors, medical doctors, they don't do social media. And I want like us to show other aspects of ladies. We have a lot of perspective of ladies on social media, but I want to show these aspects of the academics and the people who are driven, who want to be consultants like Nani, who have nice words to say. So if you want her to come again, please let me know down in the comment section below. Yeah, but Nani, do you have any other thing you want to say? Or
I am very happy and excited I got to do this video. I am so, so happy. One thing I know I'm very passionate about, I'm passionate about quite a number of things, but one thing I know I'm very passionate about is seeing that women are empowered, seeing that we can encourage ourselves and not the stereotypical, oh, we're always pulling ourselves down. No. We can change that stereotype. We can encourage ourselves. We can be happy for each other. We can help each other succeed. As a young woman out there, you have your goals. You have your ambition. You are driven. You want to, you know where you're going to, and you want to be able to get there. Surround yourself with people. Feed your soul and your spirit with these things that would increase your passion. So I'm so happy to be here, and I would I mean, if success stories come out of this, I'm really happy.
Yeah, before you go, I know we're both Christians, so I want to touch a bit about that. Okay. Because you mentioned it, we're both Christians. It's going to be the last question. Okay. For me personally, I know God has played a big role in my life and my dreams, because you could dream everything you want, but without God, you're not going anywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I want to speak a bit about that, how your faith in God has helped you through your career so far.
Wow. Oh, geez. It's a really deep one, because God is everything to me, and my relationship with God is something that has grown. I mean, no human being is perfect, but that statement should not be used as an excuse to then become rebellious towards God, because even the Bible says rebellion is like witchcraft. So God has played so many important roles in my life. I didn't know how I would be doing a PhD today. I just knew that I was going to do my master's, and I didn't know I was going to do two masters for that matter. And I have two in the bag, and now I'm about to bag the PhD. So God has been faithful. God has been everything to me. But one thing I would tell you is, you cannot lie to God, because He puts that name. God himself is not a liar. He doesn't speak with water in his mouth. The Bible says he speaks once and we hear it twice. So you would, if God speaks once, you would definitely hear it twice. And he will keep repeating that thing until you take the first step. You cannot lie to God. Tell God how you feel. Tell him what you need. That's the only way you will get through. I'm going to quote a scripture. I think in Psalm 19, the late part of Psalm 19 or the early part of Psalm 20. I can't really remember which Psalm now, but David was more or less, I'm going to paraphrase this. David was more or less saying that, expose the hidden intentions of my heart, the secret places of my heart that I don't want. Everybody has a secret place in their heart and their head that they don't want to ever open up. But when you open that up, it's God that gives you that strength to walk through it. So he's holding your hand, he's carrying you through it. So one thing I'll tell you is, if you're a Christian, you're a Muslim, you believe in God, the bottom line, the baseline is you believe in God. Stick to it, expose it to God. Only God can help you. The strength to move on, the courage to carry on, the grace to finish, he can help you. So God is everything to me. And I'm a Christian. The Bible says he is I am that I am. That is, I am who you say I am to you. If you say God is your, if you say God is your provider, he will be that provider to you. If you, that's why we can dig into dialects, Nigerian dialects, and come up with interesting names. We come up with Oniduromi. That's the one that guarantees me. You're looking for a guarantor, someone, then God pulls someone from nowhere to stand as a guarantor for you. So yes, he is who you say he is to you. Anything you name, he would be that. So
yeah, so that's it. Thank you so much. thank you so much, Nene. I can't even thank you enough. You've said so many things in this video that I know that young ladies, people out there, male or female, could learn from. Starting from MBA, business school, you spoke about law, you spoke about encouragement, hard work, discipline, you spoke about God. So I can't even thank you enough for agreeing to do this. So thank you so much. Is it okay for people to follow you on Instagram? And
yes, it is.
Yeah, so we're going to put her Instagram somewhere in this video just so you can follow her and hopefully ask her questions or things. I'm sure she's happy to help.
Yes, I'm happy to answer questions. I have to put out a caveat out there. I am not the Instagram influencer. You will hardly see pictures on my page, and I do not post quotations or inspirational things. I'm more of a one-on-one person. If you ask me questions, I'm happy to answer them. If you slide into the DM and ask me questions, intellectual questions or encouraging questions, I'm happy to answer them.
Yeah. I want to say thank you to Miss Nene for taking time out to actually do this video for us. And if you really learned anything from the conversation I had with her, and if you've learned any lesson, please put your comments down below. Tell me the most interesting thing you think she said. Just let us know, because by you putting a comment, it allows YouTube to promote the videos to other people with similar interests. So thank you so much, Miss Nene. Her Instagram handle is going to be somewhere in this video. You can always contact her. You should contact her if you have any academic related topics or life related topics that she could help you with, because she's really busy and she wouldn't have time to have just social conversations. You can always follow her on Instagram and on Twitter. I also want to say thank you to everybody who subscribed to my channel so far and has taken time out to comment on my videos. Thank you to each and every one of you for your support. If you're new here and you have not yet subscribed, please take time out to subscribe to my YouTube channel by hitting the red button below. Also like and share my videos, and don't forget to click the notification bell so you always know when I upload. Thanks guys, see you next week. Bye guys.